Hello fellow YouTubers, this is the Great DK and welcome to my very first video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to configure a mouse recorder pro. For the program download link, I'm going to put it down in the description below. But now let's hop straight into the program. Before we go into over the recording part of the program, we're going to set up some settings. It's very simple. Let's go over to edit, then settings, and make sure the minimize to tray automatically is checked. What this will do whenever you start recording the program will minimize to the tray so that it doesn't interfere with your screen and your clicks when you actually record. The rest of this we can leave as default, and this is a very important part. We want to set up our key bindings so when we actually start recording or start playing, we can actually stop it with a key bind and not get stuck in an endless loop. When you first get the program, there's going to be a couple of modifiers and some random keys here. It's a total personal preference what you do here. I just like to do F9 and F10 because that's my Fraps recording and it's pretty simple for me, so I keep it at that. Pretty much you can just exit out there right now. Say hello hand and my shitty mouse as well. Now, after we finished our settings, now we can actually go into the recordings part of the program. As you can see here, my event log is filled up with a previous recording I did. If we want to make a new one, we're obviously going to have to clear this event log. The way we want to do that is we're going to press new, and then yes. So now as you can see, we have a fresh event log for our new script. Let's actually do a little recording test here. Let's open up these two files and close them down. Let's actually do that. Press record, open them up. Close them down, press F9. So F9 is our shortcut we set before for stopping the actual recording. So let's actually test this and see if this actually works. Let's press play. As you can see, my hand was obviously now on the mouse and the program did all the work. So that's pretty much for one loop. Type of scripts. Now if we want to loop this click sequence multiple times, we're gonna have to go, first of all, we're gonna have to edit the event log. It's nothing scary, it's just delete the last line if you stop the recording with F9 so it doesn't actually loop the stop as well. Now we're going over to advanced, and over here we can see two options. The first option is times to play script, which obviously tells you how many times you want the script to be played. Any number above 0 will obviously set the exact amount of repeats, and 0 will actually just set it to infinite number of times. The reason it was very important for us to set up our keybinds before and my F10, which means if I set to an infinite number of repeats, if I don't have that F10 set up, then that means I will be pretty much locked into the endless loophole that I cannot get out of. So make sure to keep that in mind. So we're going to set it to loop 2 times, and we're going to set it to loop, let's say, 20% faster. And let's actually do that, and press OK, and do the same recording we did before, just press play. Again, hand off the mouse, still working, 20% faster, 2 times, there we go. So pretty much any number you set, it's going to do it that many times. And that's pretty much it for the editing the events. And now the last two options you can see here is the save and load function. I would recommend using this save path, going first to file, then project, then save project as, because only if you do it like this will you be able to actually determine the exact path you want the actual project to be saved in. So for testing purposes, we're going to go over to the to desktop, and we're going to save it as tutorial, and we're going to press save. And now we can close this down, and we can see it showed up over here. Now if we open this up, it's going to open the same exact event log that we had from before, from the last double loop recording, even saved. But here's the catch. It saves the event log, but does not save you the advanced options. So every time you want to run the previous recording, you're going to have to go to the advanced options and actually set the amount of times you want the program to be looped. Now that we have that out of the way, so pretty much this is the same exact one. I'm going to prove it. There we go. They're the same exact thing once. So that's pretty much it. Nothing else to it. It's your imagination and what you want to do with it. It's pretty much the options are endless. And again, if this video helped you guys out, please make sure to hit that like button, share the video, and as well, click the subscribe button if you want to see more videos from me. I'm going to be doing more of these tutorial videos, and as well a couple of WoW videos since I'm currently raiding. And if you want to stay in touch, do that, and I would very much appreciate it. It helps me out a lot, and I hope to see you in my next video. See ya.